Welcome to the Gummy Bear Show.
Okay, guys, we've got a holiday to prepare for. Granny Peters is home making cookies. Harry's compiling our Christmas music playlist. And Gummy, for the gajillionth time, you're supposed to be getting the Christmas tree.
No problemo, Kala. And I guarantee the biggest and the best.
Yikes. It says there's a huge snowstorm up in the North Pole.
Maybe Santa won't be able to deliver presents to all the kids around the world. I wonder if I should offer to help.
Hey, he's Santa. I'm sure he can make it through a little lousy weather. Ha ha, there! That might even be him coming down the chimney right now.
Hey, you know there are definite disadvantages to landing butt first.
Tell me about it.
Hello, weird-looking reindeers who just dropped down the chimney uninvited.
Great. Now I got sore ears to go with my sore butt.
Have you guys ever heard of this crazy new invention called knocking on the front door?
Sorry, lady. Force of habit.
What are you doing here?
We were just flying by and we overheard what your green pal just said. He's right. Santa is trapped in the North Pole, too snowed in to make all his usual toy deliveries.
What can we do?
Exactly what you said, Gummy. The big guy needs help with his local deliveries.
So, I hereby appoint you Deputy Santa, and you Deputy Elf.
And here's a map of where you'll be delivering the presents.
What presents?
Those ones.
I wonder if I've made enough. You can never have too many holiday treats.
Come on, we've got all these presents to deliver. This scooter riding stuff seems to be more complicated than I thought.
Yoo-hoo! Christmas treats!
Delicious! Thanks!
Any idea which way it is to the North Pole?
Gummy. Oh, man! Turkey! I was so busy ordering everybody around, I forgot to get the turkey!
Bamboozy! If we want to finish in time to still get the tree, then have a great holiday meal with Granny Peters and Kala, we're gonna have to pick up the present delivering pace, Harry! Until this last gift is delivered. Oh no! It's for Grumpy McCrab! Delivery from Mr. McCrab!
He's too grubby to accept any deliveries today.
But...
It's not easy staying crabby throughout the holidays, but I always do my best. I haven't had this much fun in years! All I can say is, I hope the gift is horrible.
With any luck, it'll be the absolute worst. Well, so long. You're out of turkeys? Really?
All out of turkeys. Are you sure? No, spaghetti with ketchup on it isn't a perfectly fine substitute for turkey.
No, no. We're doomed.
Okay, along with our lovely tree, there was a minor problem with the turkey. So, we will be having a Christmas feast of delicious stale cheese and crackers.
Since we're coming clean, I hope you like your cookies well done, as they are just a little overbaked.
To top it off, when Gummy and I were making Santa's deliveries earlier, none of our names were on the list, so there won't be much in the way of presents this year either.
Oh, this Christmas is a total disaster. So why are we all laughing?
I guess because, total disaster or not, we've still got a lot to be thankful for. We're here together with friends sharing a fun meal, even if it's slightly weird. Hey, what more could anyone want for the holidays? Merry Christmas, everybody!
Merry Christmas, Gummy!
Who could that be?
The Easter Bunny?
If so, he's either really late or really early.
Santa!
Ho, 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 ho! I'm just passing by to thank you guys for helping out earlier with my deliveries. Now, I'd better leave since I've got a busy night ahead of me. By the way, did you like your presents?
What presents?
Those ones.
Wubba dubba!
Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas, everybody!
Christmas is coming, Christmas is coming, Christmas is coming, Christmas is coming, Christmas. It's Christmas time!
Yikes! It's freezing in here! Is Kala up yet?
Morning, Hare!
Kala, watch out! The floor! It's slippery.
Thanks, Harry!
Okay, I'll admit we seem to have a minor heating challenge. All right, a major heating challenge. Either way, step one is to identify the problem, and fortunately, I have.
So have I. Global warming.
A broken furnace.
Maybe we should check outside first to see if the problem is the same everywhere?
OMG, what if it's worse out there?
Look, let's just try and figure out why Gummy's place is freezing.
True. But while doing that, you've got to admit, it is pretty cool to have our very own indoor winter wonderland in here.
Enough of this foolishness! We've got a problem to solve!
Okay, I've taken the liberty of making a few simple calculations.
Simple calculations? Look, guys, I really think we should first check outside.
Haven't you been listening, Gummy? It could be worse out there.
Maybe even worse than worse.
And trust me, that's not good.
Okay, if you two are so determined to argue, at least I can keep you a bit warmer while you do.
Quite obvious that the thermocouple was angle, which would allow it to work.
Climate change. Because sometimes people find the weather colder.
Failure of the part because of the
and
angle.
And draw the ridiculous conclusion.
Too hot for a Series 5 dual bevel 437E thermocouple, which this clearly is!
The key to keeping warm while you try and figure this out is to keep active, right? So, if you've absolutely got to argue, at least do it to a beat! You're wrong! You're wrong! And I'll prove it before long! Your solution's like totally absurd! Get your knife and fork, gonna make you eat them words! You're wrong! I'll prove it before long, cause you're both wrong, 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 wrong. Absolutely, positively, really, truly, really, bluely wrong.
Look, this is getting us nowhere. We've got to get busy working out the details of my...
Yeah, my solution, since you're obviously too stubborn to...
Does anybody have a remote control to mute these two?
Oh, forget it.
The best way for everybody to keep warm is pretend that the cold just doesn't exist.
Ice, ice, gummy. It's freezing inside. The floor's a sheet of ice. What happened last night? Has winter come early? I can't feel my toes. My buns do feel frosty, and I got a red nose.
Wonderful warm day at the beach. Why are we freezing our buns off?
Hey, I realize things aren't perfect, but sometimes life is a question of making the best out of what you're given. Huh, I mean, why? Whoa, when you can. Either way, I still really think we should check outside to see if the problem's everywhere or not.
All right, but just to turn off the broken record. Oh, it wasn't a broken furnace.
It wasn't global warming.
If you eliminate the impossible, then what's left must be true, no matter how improbable. Right, Gummy?
Huh? I mean, absolutely. I just remembered something. When I was dreaming last night of the heat wave in the Sahara, while I was testing out my new Parker and thermal long johns, I may have kind of slightly, perhaps possibly got up and while sleepwalking... we should all head out while we're waiting for my place to heat back up.
Sounds like a plan.
Careful, that floor might still be slippery. Your turn to get it.
I got it last Tuesday. It's Carla's turn.
Wrong, because I got it twice the day before that. So you and Gummy both owe me an extra get it.
Do not.
Do too.
Okay, I'll admit that you got it twice, but you're forgetting that I already traded you that extra get it when you got the bigger piece of cake. That was your extra get it. Got it?
Was not.
Was two.
Double double was not.
Double double was two.
Back me up here, Gummy.
Double double was maybe. Look, I'll just get it.
Don't you dare. It's
his turn.
Her turn.
Well, whoever's turn it is, it seems kind of silly for us all to.
What?
Hello, neighbors. I had a few extra, so I thought I'd bring you over a plate of my absolute favorite donuts.
Gee, thanks, Granny Peters.
Hope you like them as much as I do. Bye.
Well, that sure was nice of her.
The thought was, anyway. But the donuts look, well, kind of strange.
They do, don't they? I've never actually seen donuts that look like these before. How about you guys?
Well, the whole part in the middle looks pretty familiar, but all the rest of it is, well...
weird.
You're just saying that because you're a picky eater.
Not as picky as you. Or you either, come to think of it.
Hey, I'll admit I may be slightly picky when it comes to trying new foods, but that still doesn't make me anywhere near as picky as you two.
The weird thing is that half the time in the end, you wind up liking it. Not that you'd ever admit you were wrong.
Sure, I'd admit it. It's just that I'm never wrong.
Me neither. Never, never.
Or at least, hardly ever.
So, good thing none of us are picky eaters. And if ever we were, we'd admit that we were wrong if it wound up being good.
Exactly.
Double exactly. Still, we probably shouldn't be rude and not even, you know, taste them.
True. True.
After you.
Actually, I had a big breakfast just last Saturday. You first.
Normally I'd say grand, but I just ate a grape a few hours ago.
Me too. A really big one, so I'm feeling pretty full.
After you.
It was okay, I guess.
Not bad.
Could have been worse.
I suppose we should
finish it off.
I mean, just to be polite, right?
One donut left.
Getting us nowhere. Let's just store that last donut for the night in the fridge. It'll be safe there.
Good night, little circle of joy.
Sleep tight.
Sweet dreams.
I was just getting some shoe polish.
I just wanted to make sure the donut was comfortable. It's pretty chilly inside that fridge.
I was, sleepwalking.
Okay, as great as the honor system may be, there's also something to be said for the very latest in high-tech security.
I want it, I need it, I'm hungry, want to eat it, can't find it.
it, my precious, been looking everywhere. Who took it, I hid it, who ate it, someone did it. I dreamed of it all night, it just doesn't fit. Where did it go? Where can it be? Some has taken it away from me. Say, is there a mouse here in the house? It is a mystery, who can it be? I want it, I need it, I'm hungry, want to eat it. Can't find it, my precious, been looking everywhere. Who took it, I hid it, who ate it, someone did it. I dreamed of it all night, it just doesn't fit.
You ate it!
No, you did!
You both did!
How dare you accuse me of eating it when I know with absolute certainty that you probably, maybe, might have eaten it! You Eggs Benedict Arnold!
And how dare you accuse me!
Sure! I'm not supposed to accuse you, but it's perfectly fine and dandy for you to accuse me! And while we're at it, he called me a scrambled eggs or something.
Did not.
Did two.
Did three.
Yoo-hoo. I rang the door, but nobody answered.
Either way, I know I didn't eat it. So why don't the two of you at least come clean and admit that you both did? You donut rustlers.
Did not.
Did two and three.
Actually, I ate it. I noticed you left it, so I thought you didn't like them.
You
ate
the last donut?
Farewell, little round friend.
So long, sweet one.
We'll never, ever, ever forget you.
I had no idea you loved them so much. Stay here. I'll be right back. Hope you like them. Bye.
So long, Granny Peters. And thanks.
Oh, I'm a gummy bear. Yes, I'm a gummy bear. Oh, I'm a yummy.